We have to make an effort to understand and go beyond these rather difficult times. My favorite poet was Aeschylus, and he once wrote, "Even in our sleep, pain which cannot forget falls drop by drop upon the heart, until in our own despair, against our will, comes wisdom through the awful grace of God." What we need in the United States is not division. What we need in the United States is not hatred. What we need in the United States is not violence and lawlessness, but love and wisdom and compassion toward one another, and a feeling of justice towards those who still suffer within our country, whether they be white or whether they be black. So let us dedicate ourselves to what the Greeks wrote so many years ago: to tame the savageness of man and make gentle the life of this world. Let us dedicate ourselves to that and say a prayer for our country and for our people. Thank you very much.
We got 85% of the black vote.
Oh!
85%!
Oh, don't you just wish everyone was black? What?
No.
Bob.
Yeah?
Bobby, I just got a call from the chief of police. He said a man was spotted on the rooftop with a rifle.
Leave it.
Bob!
They're gonna shoot. They're gonna shoot.
The fledgling presidential campaign of Robert Kennedy continues with wins in Indiana and Nebraska. But this week's Oregon contest, with its large block of conservative voters, poses a stiffer challenge for the candidate.
Let me ask you a question.
Can I borrow that?
Let me ask you a question. How many of you support the war in Vietnam? If you want to get into this, let's get into it. How many of you support the war in Vietnam? All right, now how many of you are in college? And how many of you believe in college deferment for the draft? So you're all for sending the poor of this country, the blacks and the Latinos, to fight the war for you while you stay here safe in your classrooms. Well, you may want to think about that, because I think there's something wrong with that logic.
Yeah, but I think there's a silver lining. I think we can use that footage. I mean, we can use it in California. I don't think we use it.
Drew Pearson just called. He's writing a column tomorrow that says you authorized FBI wiretaps on Martin Luther King in early 1962 and again in October 63. He wants to know if we have a comment.
Well, you can relax, Adam. It isn't true. This is just Johnson throwing rocks at me, and we can expect a lot more of this.
So, what's our comment then? Flat-out denial?
Well, just leave it to me. I'll deal with it. You know, I never would have allowed Hoover to tap King if I wasn't so afraid of what he had on Jack.
Yes, you would have. You were different then. You didn't trust King any more than Hoover did.
So how are we going to respond?
Well, the article is going to say that you bugged King. But technically, you only authorized phone taps, which is different than bugging.
So we deny that we bugged, and then we tiptoe around the tapping?
Yeah, that's the only way.
Did you see Adam's face? He was so disappointed.
It's a rough game. I'll get used to it.
Do you really think I was different then?
Yeah, I do.
Mike? Yes, it is. Well, we expected it. No, sure. I'll see you tomorrow. Good night. We lost Oregon. No son of Joe Kennedy's ever lost an election before today.
Bobby!
Well, hey, the sky's not falling, is it?
No. Doesn't seem to be.
You're gonna win this. Nobody can beat you. Nobody except yourself.
California. I think I might be going all the way. I gotta go give my speech now. So I just wanted to say I love you. And I'll see you soon.
What I think is clear is that we can work together in the last analysis, and that what has been going on in the United States over the period of the last few years, the division, the violence, the disenchantment with our society, the division whether it be between the blacks and the whites, or the poor and the more affluent, or between age groups, or the war in Vietnam, is that we can start to work together. We're a great country, an unselfish country, a compassionate country, and I intend to make that my basis for running over the period of the next few months. So my thanks to all of you, and it's on to Chicago, and let's win there.
You did it!
Thank you.
Cesar Chavez is here.
I know. I want to see him.
Well, we're never going to find him here. We better catch up with him upstairs.